Right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make my own bail for the top part of this pendant. I really like the artistic wire. We have 22 gauge and we have 20 gauge. 22 gauge is thinner and I prefer to use the 20 gauge. So I'm going to cut a piece that is approximately, I always cut extra, but it's about 6 inches. Put my guard back on the wire. Now I take my pendant, this will be the front, put it through, and what I need on this side is approximately 1 inch, and everything else will be the part I'm going to be wrapping. So I'm going to fold up, fold the longer one up, and what I'm going to do is crisscross them. To start the bail. You want to make sure that when you crisscross them that you're not so tight on the crystal that you'll end up cracking the crystal. So first things first, I'm going to be wrapping up this wire. So I'm going to slightly straighten this wire just down here where they crisscross. So I just put a little divot into that wire. And with my finger, because the wire is so soft, I'm just going to take this wire and just wrap this around a couple of times and cut this. And then with my pliers, I'm just going to make sure that there's no rough edges, everything's tucked in. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make my loop and then come back down. So using my round tip pliers, so right here it's just wrapped loosely, I'm going to bend 90 degrees. Using my finger, roll over, take my pliers out, put it back in, roll under. Switch hands, and I'm going to come back down. And I'm going to wrap, 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 wrap over my other one. Once again. If I have to turn my loop, that's the front, I can turn the loop easily as well. If I want it facing, I can just put it in my fingers and turn that as well. So there's a quick and easy bail.